In 2020, DK Metcalf took his game to the upper level in the NFL of wide receivers. The top tier, the upper echelon. And it started week one in Atlanta when he just ran right past the corner right here. Just swatted him out of the way, and Russell just laid it out there. And just like that, DK Metcalf had his first touchdown of the season. But I think when you watch him run this double move up at the top, you can't help but think, is this, could this possibly be the next Julio Jones? Because he sure looks like it. He sure looks like he's got the size, the athletic ability, the endurance, the speed, the playmaking ability that Julio's had for the last decade. And then you go week two, home opener for Seattle. Here he is in the slot against the Patriots' best defender, all right? The reigning defensive player of the year. And Stephon Gilmore, as talented as he is, he could not stay with DK Metcalf on this move right here. That post corner route right there, not only does he make the catch, but he finishes it in the paint. In two games, he had two touchdowns, and he was beating the league's best corners. I mean, here he is, up at the top against Gilmore. And his ability, his strength right here at the top of his route to get that kind of separation against one of the league's premier cover corners didn't make any difference to him. And then by the time they got to Dallas, he was off and running. I mean, just running right by Trevon Diggs right here. Little double move right there at the top, and Russell Wilson put it right on him. But he learned from this. Don't let up in this business. Bad things can happen when you let up. And he's got to learn from that mistake. That probably will only happen once to DK Metcalf. Ball punched out of the back of the end zone, touchback, Dallas's ball, 20-yard line going the other way. So, in dramatic fashion, he makes amends. Down 31-30 to the Cowboys. Under 2 minutes to go. Situation, 3rd and 3. Russell Wilson's looking for DK Metcalf. Going across the field, just eyeing the ball the whole way, and finishing right there for the game winner. Dramatic fashion. There'd be a couple of those on the season for DK Metcalf. Finished with 83 catches, over 1,300 yards. And then down here against Miami, going up against the best. 10 interceptions from Xavier Howard. But even Xavier Howard right here, maybe even with safety help, didn't make any difference. DK Metcalf was getting behind every single good defense in the league. And in the first month, Russ was cooking. Remember that hashtag, let Russ cook? Well, DK was a big part of it. Just clear it out. Just get the ball to your big dog's ex-receiver right there. Let him finish it. Make guys miss. And get to top speed in a hurry. Big chunk plays. It was difficult keeping him out of the end zone.
And the quick out to Metcalf. Metcalf breaks a tackle, gets a first down, racing down the sideline.
Then here, against Minnesota, up at the top. It was like a repeat and a replay of the Egg Bowl. DK Metcalf against Cameron Dantzler from Mississippi State. Hail State. Well, hail DK in the end zone right there. He was cooking, Russell was cooking, and then again, in dramatic fashion, trying to get to 5-0, down 26-21 with 20 seconds to go. It was 4th and 6. Where would Russell Wilson look? He would look only for DK Metcalf on the crossing route right here. And there's not a slither of opening right here. But somehow Russell finds him, and the hands that DK Metcalf had, strong, big, big mitts, big target right here. Russell Wilson just lays it in there with anticipation. Beautiful throw. Game winner. Seattle jumped off to a 5-0 start. DK Metcalf was a big part of it. By the time you got to week 8, Seattle took control of the NFC West against Jason Brett at the bottom. These kind of routes, like crisp, sharp, comeback routes, double moves, you name it. He had the whole arsenal, beating Brett right there for 15 yards. And then the opening score of the game up at the top. I mean, 46 yards, and just like that, Seattle jumped on top of San Francisco, but he outran the entire secondary of the 49ers. Now he got the train rolling, and there was nothing the 49ers could do to keep him out of the paint. He'd score twice. He had 12 catches in this game, 161 yards. Dominant performance right here. And then this one right here. Russell just sticks it right into his bicep right there. Two touchdowns. Seattle runs away with it. And then the following week, up in Buffalo, going up against Tre'Davious White, a first-team All-Pro corner a year ago, one of the league's premier cover corners. Wasn't really anything Tre'Davious could do. He got on top of him, stacked him, And then Russell Wilson dropped it in the bucket. 41 yards against Tre'Davious White. It was 4th and 5 here, garbage time. Buffalo put up a big 40 burger on Seattle's defense this day. But DK Metcalf helped keep him in the game a little bit to the very end. Just a stick throw and tight coverage. Beat the zone look right there. Just a quick jab, like an ollie jab. Got that ball in there. And then week 12, he came to Philadelphia. Darius Slay was brought from Detroit to be able to cover the big dogs in this league. He said it was the worst game he ever played. DK Metcalf torched him all game long. Big plays, you name it. Biggest game of the season, 10 catches, 177 yards, a lot of them against Slay. Right here, put this game on ice. Up 17-9, gonna make this big spray fade throw right here. Spray fade route, Slay's right in his grill, didn't matter. When that ball hit his chest, he straps it to his chest. And the cameras are all there to catch it in prime time. DK, a rising star in this whole business. And then it came to a playoff game, week 18. Super wild card weekend. Kept Seattle in this game. This is just the old scramble drill right here. They got him all zoned off. But what do? You go deep. Somebody go deep. Russell will find you. And he did. He got behind the zone, 51-yard touchdown. He shows up in the postseason now. He's played 3 postseason games. He's got 3 touchdowns in the postseason. This one, yeah, it's a little bit of garbage time right here, but still, zone defense, they're just trying to play a little Star Wars defense, keep it all in front of them. But right here, 3 touchdowns, 3 postseason games. But one thing we saw this year is this matchup up at the top, Jalen Ramsey and DK Metcalf, is always going to be a game within a game. Because Jalen's the one guy in this business right now that can really play DK Metcalf. He's got the size, the reach, the athletic ability, the speed. And when the ball's in the air, I'm not sure anybody is better. I mean, there's a lot of great corners in this league, but I'm not sure anybody is better than Jalen Ramsey right now. But that's a matchup to look forward to. Twice a year, who knows, maybe 3 times a year, the way it played out this year, DK Metcalf and Jalen Ramsey going to be a great showdown every week. It was a great year for DK Metcalf, upper echelon, top tier receiver in this business.